Hello everyone, myself Dr. M.SRUJAN Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. Today's topic is in continuation with part 1 and part 2 of different types of dosage form. So part 1 I have dealt with solid type of dosage form and part 2 I have dealt with liquid type of dosage form. The example for part 1 I have quoted tablet as a solid type of dosage form. The example for part 2 liquid type of dosage form, I have quoted an example. There are two types of liquids, mono and biphasic. Mono I have quoted syrups and biphasic I have quoted suspensions and emulsions. So today's topic is about another type of dosage form called as semi-solid type of dosage form. So what do you mean by the term semi-solid? Semi-solid is nothing but a substance that exists in between your solid and liquid. Okay, when you say that exists between solid and liquid, solid is a kind of a substance that can hold its shape and liquid is a kind of a substance that can freely flow. So any substance that exists in between this is called as semi-solid. So that means that in another way we can say semi-solid is a substance that cannot hold its shape and that cannot flow freely as liquid. So that kind of substance is called as semi-solid. So coming to the examples of semi-solids, so household example we can give mayonnaise as an example for semi-solid type of dosage form. Okay, so and coming to the pharmaceutical side, the examples we can quote such as ointments, creams, gels, etc. Today we will move on to defining ointment and cream. What do you mean by the term ointment? Ointment is a semi-solid type of dosage form. So based upon the nature, we can say it as a semi-solid. What it contains? It contains API. API is nothing but active pharmaceutical ingredient and excipients. Why excipients are required? Any dosage form requires excipients. Why? In order to fabricate into a suitable type of dosage form. So it contains API and excipients. Now the question comes, what is the route of administration of your ointments? There are n number of routes of administration for ointment. The routes of administration like topical route of administration, okay, and nasal route of administration, ophthalmic route of administration, rectal route of administration, vaginal route of administration, mucosal route of administration, nasal route of administration. These are the routes of administration of your ointment. When you say ophthalmic, something that is instilled into your eye is called as ophthalmic. Something that is placed inside your nose, it is called as nasal. Something that is placed into rectal is called as rectal route of administration. Something that is placed into your vagina, that is called as vaginal route of administration. Something that is placed onto your skin, it is called as topical route of administration. These are the n number of routes of administration for your ointments. In a simple, you can say it as topical, or if you can remember some routes of administration of ointments, you can say nasal, ophthalmic, topical route of administration, rectal, etc. So what is the purpose of using an ointment? For desired therapeutic effect. As I said, any dosage form is given to a patient in order to achieve desired therapeutic effect. So if you want to define, ointments are semi-solid type of dosage form that contains API and other ingredients intended for topical, ophthalmic, nasal, rectal, etc. for desired therapeutic effect. Now, how to define creams? Creams are semi-solid type of dosage form that contains API and other ingredients intended for the same routes of administration, topical, ophthalmic, nasal, rectal, etc. for desired therapeutic effect. Now the question is, what is the difference between the ointments and creams? The primary difference will be based upon the consistency. Okay, if you see the consistency of ointment and cream separately, ointments will have more consistency when compared to the cream. So consistency is based upon the viscosity of your dosage form. So ointments will have more viscosity when compared to the cream. In what way? These viscosities will influence your formulation. See, ointments, as they are having more viscosity, they are going to adhere to your biological membrane for a prolonged period of time when compared to your cream. Okay. So this is the difference, primary difference between your ointment and cream. Apart from that, when you look after your formulation aspects, there are n number of differences, like based upon the concentration of the lipids used and all. Okay, that is out of the topic. Then, apart from that, there is some important thing to be discussed for ointments and creams. So, the principle used in the preparation of ointments and creams is emulsion-based principle. So, when you say emulsions, don't get confused with your liquids. As I already said you in the part 2 that liquids are divided into two, monophasic and biphasic. Under biphasic, I have discussed something about suspension and emulsions. At that point, I have given a clear note that emulsion is not a dosage form, it is a principle used in the preparation of a dosage form. For example, if you say calamine lotion, already I have quoted an example in part 2. Calamine lotion, the dosage form is a lotion. But if you check with the ingredients and the principle used in the preparation of that particular calamine lotion, suspension is the principle used in the preparation of your calamine lotion. Okay, is it clear? So, here also emulsion is a principle used in the preparation of your dosage form. When you say liquid emulsion, so emulsion is a principle, dosage form is a liquid dosage form. When you say ointment, emulsion is a principle, dosage form is a semi-solid type of dosage form. When you say cream, emulsion is a principle, the dosage form is semi-solid type of dosage form. So, emulsions and suspensions are the principles used in the preparation of the dosage form. You need to have a clear understanding on this particular context. Okay, so that you can easily define any type of dosage form. Thank you for watching my video. We'll meet you with a different dosage forms in the next video. Thank you very much.